So, hello. This time not streaming and also not using the headset because I have to leave by train soon and then just looking what I can do, where I can this looks interesting. Because I got my license now, and now I have to change the working place, and I have to pack many things for my new home, basically. So I have to be very careful. What will I need now in the very beginning there? What can I get here? That's important, and yeah. And I also want to leave by train now, because usually I should have left maybe already yesterday, but I didn't. Just because, yeah, I don't know. I wanted to see all these matches from TGL players and didn't want to have the big stress, but it would be very weird to drive by train, go by train very late today as well. Oh, yeah. That was close. Interesting map, probably by Eternity. Yeah. Interesting. So I will just drive the live rounds mostly, but on these new maps I'm gonna try also the other round, the warm-up, so that I know the way. So currently having a look at all the papers that I have here, because I definitely need to sort all the paper a bit better now and not just put it into my bag, and then when I put it out of the bag in the new home, I'm again like, ugh, so what is this? What is this? Where to put it? It's just too crazy. So what is that? That's okay, nothing I need right now. Okay. I don't see. I don't think that's important here. Okay. I don't need that. So, next warm-up, next new map. Only a minute warm-up. Already previous warm-up I was not able to finish. What is quite annoying is that I have no sound. That's because I have to check after this map. Why do I have no sound? Ah no, I have sound. The headset is plugged in. But I have to make sure to find a way here. Okay, Eternity is building a lot of interesting looking maps. Mapper of the Year. Knockout Mapper of the Year, probably 2020. I didn't see now what to do there. So add some cars and try to be not in front of them, so I know what to do. As now I wasn't sure, I just stopped. I saw this yellow bumper on the road. Ach, gut. I found it. So yeah, I said I want to stream without headset, but no. It's currently plugged in, but then I don't hear anything myself, so I will plug it off. Quality is a bit different then. That's actually something that I need. Yeah. That is something that I don't need. So that comes here. And then I have multiple. Still something. Okay. Let me check, okay. I should start driving. I think this is the map that I know. Yeah. Rip. Didn't even cost me a position though. Okay. So I have a bunch of papers that I can get here that are not so important. But these papers I want to take with me. Okay. Gut. The next thing that I want to do is yeah, the next thing that I want to do is eating while playing Knockout. This is something I'm afraid of, because I know this can happen. This is still the old version. I think there has been a new version of this track. It's a peeled Runio map, and he writes minus minus, okay. I don't know what is slide and what is no slide here with my problem. It's actually a new local for me and I'm 1.78 seconds behind Mime. What a meme. Oh, Sven has to go. Sadly. Actually, in the MX Morning KOs, there is really not much time, not much waiting time. So if you want to eat something, it's difficult to do that. Because in TMX knockouts, ne, when you finish in your warm-up run and you can't continue driving afterwards, there is like such a big waiting time, ne? You can do so many things during the KO. It is really annoying with the waiting time, but the positive thing is you can eat or something. But here in the MX knockouts, as you have no waiting time in the warm-up, as you can always directly start again. Like now, huh? You only have the little waiting time at the end of the knife round, but this is usually less because people of course try to finish as fast as possible. And yeah, and halt the podium. It's not much. It's good time there. Not sure what my PB is. I hope something better than what I just did. Something much better. Because that wasn't all too well. So Bits drove a 42.3. I have a 43.0, but with excess. Mari's 89. So it's quite long ago. Yeah, Mac is also here again today. I think I will not really drive this map, maybe with one-handed keyboard. Can you force me as well? Has been forced to spectator. And the legend has gone. First time I got that, but so many others did it as well. Vielleicht. Yeah, this is a super short map, a very old one. Not sure if it was here since the first KO, but it was here very early on already. My car is steering on its own again. Yeah, do you see that? Always to the right. It's a very dangerous map because if you make one mistake, you can get knocked out. I have to be careful. I am surprised that this should be a new PB. So what is my setup here saying? Oh yeah, the dead zone is quite low. Quite low. So I will raise it. The time attack knockout, I have even less time to eat or do something else. Especially, I sometimes really have problems to eat fast when I'm in stress. For example, in my exam, I was not able to eat something. Quite annoying always. Okay, this is actually a Firestorm map. I wasn't sure if he was using such blocks. I mean, the smoothness of the dirt was telling me I might be Firestorm map. Let's see. It'll be important to get the gear up. Last turn wasn't optimal. When the knockout is done, I also need to I upload a YouTube video, the TTC. Then I need to close down my laptop and also take the Vodafone GigaCube with me because there might be internet struggles in my new home. This is a difficult map here. Okay, I didn't remember it was so tight. Damn it. How shall you take this? This track is difficult. This was already now shaky as hell. My God. Typical to Derek, man. Don't even need to see who's the map author, I know it. Crashes over crashes. Ibo out. Pietrunio Lucky. Von Lagoon. Now I don't really have free time, now I have to continue here playing, also the warm-ups, because only good players are left. Is that the map with a bunch of chicanes in the end? Oh man! This is so weird with my dead zone. On some days I can easily play with a lower dead zone, and on other days it's totally different again. I need to change it again. Look, I'm at 0.07, it shouldn't happen. And you see it again went a bit to the right. At the beginning. Nice little leg, but I survived it, very good. Now Maxi doesn't say it because I'm not in voice chat with him, but he writes it. Oh no, not this one. Ah. The one where Lars flipped over against Ryulu. Ah. Wow. Wow. Oh Gott. This is not really the best possible map right now, because we have Maxi, Piotrunio and Mime, and we get a Lagoon map. This will be definitely very tough to survive. Depending on what the next map is, it could be that the next map would be much easier to survive in the top 3 than this now. I hate this. This is so stupid, really. My car just steered to that part on its fucking own. Yes! Even got Mime. I knew Piotrunio was only half a second behind me, and this ending is so tricky. Whew. Yeah, and exactly, now we get Stadium, which is in theory easier. In theory, because Maxi can also do Stadium very well, and Mime as well. If Piotrunio was still in on such a technical map, I would say, yeah. Mime and Maxi, that's not so easy. The warm-up is so flawless. But they are not far back. Not many turns in this track. So the field that we have, I have to nail. Looks good, because now it's full speed. Close there, Maxi makes it. He doesn't? What did Maxi do? Yeah, my ending was way too safe in the last drift corner. I didn't really take the full speed out of it, so that was not too optimal. Damn, we will play a map that I don't know. This track looks like the worst possible one that I could get. Oh, it's actually also quite short. The Speedy Canyon map. Oh my god. What's the name? Left is tight, right is wide. Okay, at least I drove Canyon yesterday. Oh Gott. Okay, I have to be careful here. Crazy, we didn't have a lot of canyon. Final is a canyon now. Huh. Will be tough. Yes, 0.89. Nice. Yeah, you see half a second behind Voyager. I lost that all in the last platform, but I saw I'm half a second ahead. I lost a lot there. But I'm in front of Lars. The run wasn't too bad. It was just at the platform I completely oversteered in the end. And if he would take it perfectly, I think he could actually catch up half a second in the end. But yeah, nice. Oh. Yeah, the good thing was in the warm-up when I drove the map there, I had a decent feeling about it. Still looking, what can I take with me? What do I need? I need this. It's not easy. Oh, are we starting? Yes, we are starting, okay. So time attack is at least a much shorter kill. Oh yeah, this one. I think I have a very good time on this. Do you see that? My car is still steering on its own. Oh. I'm sorry. Third local. Wow, Pio Junior has second local, but he's super far ahead of me. So, interesting. So, also with this dead zone, it should not happen anymore. Because this is higher than what I ever had. I mean, in this map here, the last corner is basically very deciding as well. And I didn't really get that nicely. I had oversteer a lot. The thing is, if you manage to get the water grip done, yeah. Then it helps a lot. So if Minato would count all the knockouts, for the German player of the month, I would have already 6 points more. Because I won the last 6 KOs that are not giving a point in a row. If I managed to also win this one, it would be number 7. And then I don't win this evening. Well, then I don't win this evening. I would win the second evening KO, however, but I don't think that I will play this evening at all. I mean, it would be the last chance to make a point, yeah, but I'm not sure what Minato will do with Ryulu and Team GL. It was a competition with prize money, so I assume that Ryulu gets another point there, and I believe he has already 5 points and I have 4 points. And if Minato gets a 6th point there, I couldn't catch him. Only if my Team GL identity win would count. That would be the only option how it could work, that I take it. Yeah, winning the identity. This would be the extra point for me. I know that Lars likes this map a lot. I must say, I don't really understand it. Yeah, again my car steered. Today my pad has such a my stick has such a point where it goes very easily to. It's not centered. Like you know, when you buy a new pad, the stick is always going into the center easily. Yeah, but when you use the pad already since quite some time, it changes. And the pet is, yeah. That the stick is not going to the middle anymore, but maybe some other place that just works. And this changes, I have the feeling, this changes from day to day. Sometimes it actually goes into the middle for me, and then I can actually play with zero dead zone and my car goes straight. And straight. And then quickly. Oh, that took too long. And then other days it is completely different suddenly. How much time do we have in this time attack knockout? I have the feeling it's much, much less than usually. So usually we have 1 minute 40. Sometimes we had 1 minute 30, so I would already say it's 1:30. But it feels like even less, because I was not even able to do a third one. Minute 35. Huh. Okay, this map here is I had a final on this track once against Voyager. It was of course unbeatable on this kind of track. This is like the worst for me. This technical lagoon with many grip changes, where you have these weird physics also making trouble. And yeah, this is something where Voyager is just really good in. Not good at. Especially this last corner, I braked now, probably not needed, I don't know. I once had a decent run here, 24-6 by Piotrunio, is 5th. Ah yeah, I have 24.3 actually. But Voyager has a 22.6, I mean just imagine. It's Ferris Murray's 89. Uppsala. Sometimes I had decent times here, but now, no idea. I have a 0.6 here. Not sure. Do you have to go downwards the wall very quickly in the end or very slowly? That's a question. Will you take the shortest line, the most diagonal line, into the last corner? Or do you want to go down quite early? I don't know it. On this track it was quite difficult to straighten out the car in the end, even though it's a long straight. And yeah, I remember that Voyager went quite wide here and got a lot of speed due to that. Not that wide though. And I will continue. But with this dead zone, it's now also a bad try. Hmm. Yeah, you see him already behind. Yeah, there's also just such a weird track here. Now I have the start that I wanted, and now I can't finish. Yeah, watch out. Didn't. Minus 11. I have a 0.89 here. I was now at the 94 and minus 11 is 83, so this would have been pretty fast. Now this map, we usually play it after knockouts and not so often in knockouts. Okay. Here we go. I had once a very good run on this one, and it was world record with quite some margin and for quite a long time, until it got suddenly beaten. Very important here is the last corner. And you take the full width of the street, you can use a good acceleration on the outside on the ramp style beside the dirt at the tunnel exit. Other than that, this first corner is quite critical here because the exit is quite tight. You can't go onto the outside dirt here. That would cost you all the grip. So this is decent, but has still a lot of room for improvement. I'm just releasing here to make it. That's not how I want to drive. Your bits with a 0.38. This is the region where I have been with my locals though. Like this, you need to take it. You see, I have a 34, Firestorm got a 32. Not sure what this track here is. So Solide Seehund got knocked out before Polmal, and now we are approaching the difficult section of the knockout. We are already in the top 6 of the time attack knockout. Knockout round 9. And I must say, I don't really know this track. But it's quite easy to see the way at least. The ending, however, is really stupid to try, oh god. You see, this is a new local. Never drove it yet. Second look. Okay, I should be safe with this. Of course, if that was a final, I wouldn't be safe at all. There's so much potential still. Oh yes. Minus 0.444. That's good. And we have Pietrunio, Maxi, Bits is also close by, Mime and Simply Nick is out. Oh, but you see that Mime is also with a 0.24. I mean, before I improved my time, I was at a 0.1. So just barely in front. So you see how close that is. Yeah, if you can't make the last deciding run through where you still improve again, it could be already over and out. And now comes the track. In the first Lagoon Time Attack knockout overall from Lagoon, this was I think the top 3 map, and I survived it, went into the final. This was the good memory. The bad memory of this track is that I once had a final against Lars and lost because I got a snap in the last loop. I had a really good run, would have beaten Lars. But the snap killed me. You see what kind of snap, but it was turning me around in the final. Yeah, I knew that. But I believe with this finish time I'm quite safe. I can't restart now, have to take this. Okay, I'm not so safe. I'm not so safe. Bits, I saw that he finished. Holy shit, it was only 400s. Ay. Ne? This is incredible. I am first. So now exactly what I said before. I was first. But I didn't manage to finish another run. The last run where I could improve. You saw how bad my start was and I was still ahead. And I didn't finish it. And suddenly everyone else made his last try and I went down from 1st to 4th. And even Bits, who's not... The other players are very good in Lagoon. Bits, of course, a more stadium player, but even he was super close to getting it there. And this here is also a very tough track. from last to first with this run. Who's going out? It is Piotr Runio. Again, the top, same top four. I don't remember who was fifth on the first KO, but again the same top four. And again, Piotr Runio getting knocked out there. But man, the last run was really needed. Another example of what I said, yeah? Without the last run, it's quite tough. Quite tough. Good one. Will it be the same final? Seems like it. I have world record on this track. Came also close. Which picture will come? Okay, the typical multi-environment picture. And it will be... Oh no. Oh no. This is not good. Against Mime, this track, that's tough. Yeah, what is this? What is this buggy ramp? Finishing this. Rip. Ah, damn it. It was a good round. I mean, if he didn't get the world record, I would have made it. He did it at the same point as I did. I mean, I'm not unhappy with my performance here. I look, Lars is slower, Pietrunio slower, Timania slower. It was just Mime who just got the world record run into the finish. Of course, my run wasn't optimal, that's for sure. I was really having problems with this unsmooth start. Also in this last try, I actually wanted to straighten out my car already so that I jump into the first CP to the inside, but I thought, oh yeah, this car will probably overreact, so I didn't do it. And yeah, then I was when I started the run. When I started the run, I was already seeing that I can only finish once more and not twice. So if I finish this, it has to be it. Or I have to restart real quick, but then I have to decide before the last corner. And that was difficult. That was really difficult. Because you don't really have much time before the finish to decide yes or no. And yeah, the last try was... It did have this, yeah, not so perfect start, and also this weird buggy ramp there was definitely not optimal because I had to oversteer a bit on the beach. This is where I lost time, mostly. I guess he won there, and yeah, then I made the interface on, and I saw, oh, I'm 600 behind him, and decided, okay. I have to go for it now, because now I'm on a run that is close. It was a difficult decision, because I was behind him. So what do I do? Do I really restart now? But I was so close behind him, or do I try to get him with this run? Because who knows if I can get another run like that, speed-wise. Yeah. Even though I know the whole start was not optimal, but of course I can also easily crash it in another run. So here was at least a slight chance. I couldn't know how good was his end, so I just tried. But yeah, I mean, the two final maps against him were definitely not the best ones for me. I can be happy that I was able to win the first one, Canyon one. But yeah, definitely if there was Valley or Stadium, it would have been easier. And Lagoon is like the worst possible thing, but such a Lagoon map is then really the worst thing. Because I have some good Lagoon maps in Time Attack Knockout, where I'm pretty sure I could also challenge him, challenge everyone. And I mean, I would have beaten everyone else regarding the locals, yeah. So it was decent. Definitely. It was decent. Don't need to say it was bad or something. It was pretty good. Uppsala. So yeah, you will see a heat goes already to the right. So here I'm actually in front, but I steer further to the left, and this is where he catches up, and then this weird jump. And you see that he was earlier steering to the left. There he wins it a little bit. And then he went full through the water. Okay, I also went quite a lot through the water. Here. I came from more outside. I had a better angle, actually, I would say. So that in usually, if this wouldn't grip so much, yeah, I would come out on the inside of him. Because this is how usually a turn works. But he went full through the water with basically all four wheels. And it worked. It worked for him. That was quite a risky move. Because I'm also a bit risking it, but it was still controlled, I would say. But his line is quite crazy. I mean, just the angle, how he approaches the water, how far from the inside. Look, if you see that line, yeah, and there is a hairpin, would you think that he can come around the hairpin? This was only due to the water, but he really had to hit a specific line to make it. You look where he is going, and then he actually comes around. Yeah, damn it. Yeah, it's always a bit annoying when you see that that you actually didn't do much wrong, but the other guy took a huge risk and it actually worked out, and it has a chance of one of, I don't know, 10 or even worse. Because I think if he would try it again with this line, it wouldn't work, I would assume. This is really a weird angle to go into the water, and then with all four wheels into the water, and it didn't slow him down. I mean, you can of course be too much in the water, and then it's just bad. So yeah, really good for him that it worked. Because optically I would have said I had the better approach for the last corner. Just I was not able to overtake him then in the end with it. So here we see the top three, because I wanted to see what Maxi did. He was definitely on second place in the last CP. Here he was a bit wide. I had a good first corner. Oh yeah, this is not so good for Maxi. He had to slide earlier, but he's still close. Oh, and then the crash by Mime. So this is the reason why Maxi went ahead, but has not the best speed here. So, and here he is ahead of him, and it should be easy. What does he do? Oh god. Yeah, okay, this is of course not a very clever mistake by Maxi. trying to go inside there, I don't know. I mean, Mime probably had more speed, because Maxi, similar to me, had not the best exit speed out of the left corner. Definitely have to say that. So maybe he thought he will get me if I don't take the inside line. But yeah, in the end it looks of course stupid, because maybe it would have been enough. So I have already the better first drift. It's nice to see that I can actually beat someone in Canyon in like every drift extending. And here also that I turned my car already. He's even driving more safe than me in this round. This is really looking like me driving, but even safer. He also got problems there. Yeah, yeah. I remember that on this track there was a final between Lars and Ozone. Yeah, GG. So I'm gonna end the recording. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.